I would also urge this committee to deliberate upon and address any challenges towards the creation of an Asian parliament. Ladies and gentlemen, the Parliament of Pakistan has been an active member of APA in pursuit of the dream of Asian integration. After assuming presidency in 2013 for 2 years, Pakistan hosted a series of mega events of Asian Parliamentary Assembly, including 2 plenary sessions, 3 Executive Council meetings, and 1 Troika Plus meeting of APA. Most importantly, Pakistan, through the Islamabad Declaration, took the lead in laying the ideological foundations for creating an exclusive Parliament of Asia. It was during the 7th plenary session of APA at Lahore 2014 that the Senate of Pakistan led the initiative of a special committee on creation of Asian Parliament as a first stepping stone towards the creation of an Asian Parliament was created. From there, a number of initiatives followed with an aim to generate consensus and cooperation. Our commitment can be gauged by the fact that here at home, the Senate of Pakistan unanimously passed a special resolution for the establishment of an Asian Parliament on 10th March 2015. So far, 5 meetings of the SCAP and 2 meetings of 6 sub-regional groups under SCAP have been held. Regardless, we consider this a long process which will take some time to materialize. After having our target charted out, it is here that we must all converge our focus towards making tangible efforts to achieve this target. It is now critical that we must address any remaining differences and find common ground to materialize our ultimate goal of an Asian Parliament. As a leader of the House in Senate and also a representative of the ruling party, I would like to emphasize that the present government puts premium on human development and prosperity in underdeveloped provinces and areas. Balochistan and Gawadar are on our top priority. This is due to the fact that socio-economic and infrastructural development here has a direct and positive bearing on the prosperity of not just Pakistan but the whole region. Therefore, to have Asia's visionary leaders here in Gawadar, united in purpose to change the fate of teeming millions, to improve our present for a better future, is a sight to behold and a step towards a common destination. I convey our sincere thanks to the representatives of APA member and observer countries. Excellencies, we are deeply appreciative for your invaluable participation in these important APA sub-forum meetings. I have no doubt that cooperation holds the key to fulfilling expectations and aspirations that people of Asia associate with parliamentary democracy. I also convey special commendation to Honorable Sadiq Sanjrani, Chairman Senate, for having assumed the prestigious portfolio of APA, Vice President and Chair of Standing Committee on Political Affairs and SCAP. Mr. Chairman, I am confident that under your able stewardship, these two committees would show more progress in realizing their respective mandates, especially that of forming a grand Asian Parliament. And last but not the least, I would like to acknowledge the hard work and commitment by Secretary Senate Mr. Amjad Pervez Malik, his officers and staff, as this is instrumental to the successful hosting of this event. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, please accept our heartfelt welcome with abiding sentiments of goodwill. May you have a comfortable stay and a mutually rewarding experience. Thank you very much.